Welcome back, everybody. So in this video, I wanted to talk about a few more ideas that will hopefully spark your interest into learning computer organization and architecture. So in this topic, you learn a great deal of program optimization and system tuning, and this is a great way to be motivated to learn it. Now, there's also a few primary fields you can get into with this type of knowledge, and one of these is writing compilers. And remember, a compiler is just taking a language that a machine can use and translating it into a language that the machine understands at the hardware level and ultimately what the processor will read. And a compiler can take advantage of specific hardware features that will benefit speed and efficiency. So in this field, you really need to understand how the hardware works. Now, designing peripheral equipment is something you can also get into. And a peripheral device is a device that is used to put information into or get information out of the computer, such as your mouse, printer, keyboard, anything that is connecting and exchanging information in some way. To work on these devices, you need to have a firm understanding of how the I/O works, and this stands for input/output, and you'll see that term thrown out there a lot. And the image, you see all these machines have some form of input and output to a device. For embedded systems, you also need to know the I/O architectures. And an embedded system is a computer system with a dedicated function within a larger mechanical or electrical system, and it often has real-time computing constraints. So you can imagine the image here of this embedded system being a part to a whole that it would connect to and work with. Now, benchmarking techniques are very important as well, and becoming familiar with them will help you when working with hardware. It will help you especially if you become involved in research on algorithms or networks or hardware systems. So we want to learn how circuits and components work together to build these systems, and this is the study of computer organization, and it will look at how all the physical parts of a computer system work together and explain how the system works. It's the idea of how the computer works. Computer architecture, on the other hand, will show us some more logical and abstract ideas of the system's implementation. The architecture is what directly affects the logical execution of the programs, and this allows us to make design decisions about the system. So we look at computer architecture with the idea of how do we design the computer. Now that's it for this video. Thank you, everybody. If you enjoyed it, go ahead and subscribe.